My loving and grateful pranams at the lotus feet of Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba and a loving Sai Ram to my Sai family. Today, I would like to share some experiences which have impacted my life. In the year 1975, my husband, an Indian Air Force officer, Flight Lieutenant Kailasam, was posted in Secunderabad. In February of 1975, he was down with a bout of viral fever. The doctors gave him some medication and asked him to rest. One morning, he got up with numbness in his feet and he could barely stand or get dressed. He was rushed to the military hospital in Secunderabad. The doctors admitted him to the ICU and conducted various tests. He was diagnosed with a condition called transverse myelitis, a disorder of the spinal cord, which leads to paralysis. By the time he was in the ICU, he was completely paralyzed. My brother-in-law, a doctor practicing in Bombay, when he heard the news, he rushed down to Secunderabad. He consulted the doctors and came back and told us that the condition wasn't very good and my husband may not be able to walk. This was a big blow to the family. We didn't know what we were going to do. Our only refuge was Swami. We just prayed to him to help us in this time of trouble. My brother-in-law decided to go to Bangalore and have Swami's darshan. He went first to Shivam in Hyderabad, Swami's center, and he did 108 parikramas around the temple and then went to Whitefield. When he reached Vrindavan, Swami was there and he waited in darshan line, waiting for Swami to come and speak to him or come and look at him. 3 days passed. Swami didn't look at him, neither did he speak to him. He had darshan from very far away. He was completely disheartened and wondered whether his brother's life was wheelchair bound. He was completely dejected. On the fourth day, he decided that he will come back home and he slowly walked towards the gate. As he was walking towards the gate, there was a call saying, "Who is Dr. Nagaraj from Bombay?" So he immediately turned around and acknowledged that it was him. So the gentleman said, "Swami is calling you to his residence. He wants to speak to you." Nagaraj ran towards Swami's residence, weeping and crying so much. When he reached Swami and came face to face with Swami, he just couldn't utter a single word, just kept crying and sobbing. Swami patted his back and said, "Don't cry, your brother will be fine. I will take care of him." And he gave him some vibhuti and he said, "He will be fine. I will take care of him," once again. And then he said, "You bring him to me when he is discharged from hospital." So Nagaraj said, "But he is in the military hospital, Swami. They will not discharge him so easily." He said, "You don't worry about all that. I will take care of that. But you bring him to me after he is discharged." Relieved and happy with this divine assurance, Nagaraj came back to Secunderabad. Coincidentally, or should I say Sai incidentally, the time when Swami was speaking to Nagaraj was exactly the time when my husband was shifted from the ICU to the officer's ward. Swami's miracles had already begun. After various physiotherapy and medication and exercises and things, Kailasam became slightly steady on his feet. He could walk a few steps with support and slowly he was getting cured. we could see the improvement in his condition. After 3 months, he was discharged from hospital about 40 days later. Just before going home, we decided that we will take him straight from the hospital to Swami's abode, Shivam, and have Swami's darshan and thank him for this grace, and then we will come home. So we had darshan of Swami, we came back home. As I opened the door, we saw an orange silhouette walking away from us into the house. Swami's presence was felt by every single person there, and we were overwhelmed with joy and grateful for this grace bestowed upon us. After that, there was only positivity. We knew Swami was with us, so everything would be fine. After 3 months, when Kailasam became steady on his feet and could walk a little bit on his own, but generally with support, we decided we will go to Bangalore as per Swami's instructions. So we went to Whitefield and waited in darshan lines. Those days, Swami would give us darshan under a huge banyan tree with a beautiful Krishna statue. And Thrayi was not built then, nor was Sai Ramesh Hall. Swami used to live in the old bungalow. That day, Swami came out of his residence and walked straight towards the men. As he came close to Kailasam, he materialized Vibhuti, applied it on his forehead and rubbed his back with it and patted him and said, "Go and join duty." That was all. We were so overwhelmed and crying away, just looking at this scene. God had blessed us. We were crying so much that we could barely see Swami through our tears. But this divine assurance came as a big hope in our lives. Now we knew we were in safe hands, and we went back home to Secunderabad. In the next 3 months, Kailasam's condition improved quite a lot and he could walk. When he went for his 6 month review to the hospital, the panel of doctors were surprised to see him striding across the room. They had not expected a transverse myelitis patient to walk in barely 6 months' time. But then they didn't know that the doctor of doctors was there with us. With Swami's grace, Kailasam became completely normal and we were posted to Delhi. We came to Delhi at the end of the year and he was completely normal. He could walk, he could ride a two-wheeler, and we had almost forgotten that he had gone through such a condition. It was like, you know, from despair to devotion to total surrender. From that moment on, everything was dedicated to Swami. Thank you, Swami, for this great gift that you have bestowed on us. After many years, almost 40 years plus, and after Swami's Mahasamadhi, we had another miraculous experience. I was diagnosed with an autoimmune disease called GBS, which left me completely paralyzed. I was in the hospital, the ICU, on a ventilator for almost 3 weeks, and with tubes all over me and completely disheartened. I kept asking Swami, "Why am I even alive like a log of wood? Take me away, I don't want to live." But then my daughter and son-in-law, they were beside me and they said, "You can't give up like this. Swami has given you this life. You have to fight and get over this disability." And then I remembered a sentence from a Samarpan talk where the speaker says that Swami gives you a challenge, he already has a solution for it. He will give you the solution and the strength to fight this challenge. So I decided, with Swami on my side, I need not be afraid. I am going to meet this challenge and beat it. With the help of a wonderful group of physiotherapists and the doctors, with proper medication, timely attention, I was able to walk slowly, a few steps at a time, with help. But the improvement was there. I was discharged after 40 days. And my daughter and son-in-law took me to Singapore, where they live. They taught me how to walk, how to hold a pen, how to hold a spoon, how to hold a glass. Every single action that I had taken for granted, I had to relearn. And thanks to Vandana and Vijay, I am whole today. I am able to walk. I am able to eat without spilling food all over the place. I am so very grateful. When I hold a glass in my hand, I thank Swami that I am able to do this action without dropping the water, without messing it up. It was a great, great miracle for me. I was given a second lease of life. This is my second innings. Swami's grace, I am fine. It's been 2 years now and I am completely independent and able to fend for myself. Thank you, Swami, for this miracle in my life. The second innings is the greatest gift that you could have given me. Thank you once again, Swami, for your grace, your love. I dedicate every single moment of my life at your lotus feet. Jai Sai Ram.